me.
How's your day?
Busy.
Are you hungry? There's leftovers in the fridge.
I found them.
How's the shop looking?
Wasn't able to get a whole lot done. Cleaned up a little bit.
Well, that's good.
Yeah, how's your day been?
Busy.
Yeah?
What do you think?
Beautiful.
Thanks. I think the curtains really work well with that table cover.
I was talking about you.
$1,481 is your total today. Here's your change. Have a great day.
You hungry? I'm gonna open the door and throw in a bag of chips and some water. Don't try anything.
So, Eduard, I heard you've got this big project you're working on.
Oh, yeah? I told you that.
Oh, just an old friend.
Old friend, huh? Maybe that old friend of yours learned to keep her big mouth shut. No, I just bought this old garage and planning on turning it into a shop, so.
That's so great, Ed.
Yeah, really great, buddy. That's so awesome.
Thanks.
Oh! Have I told you all about the guy in the park?
No, you haven't.
I haven't told you guys about him yet?
No.
This
is so weird.
Well, I was on my morning jog. This was 2-3 weeks ago?
2 weeks ago.
2 weeks. And so I was on my routine jog and took a break, sat on the park bench and all that. And this man is also jogging, and he jogs right past me and does a double take towards me and examined me for a second and sits down next to me and starts talking about whatever and eventually gets around to asking me if I had a brother. I said, well, I had a brother. And he asked me if it was a twin. And I said, no. And then he got really quiet, stared deeper at me as if he was gazing into an abyss. Well, I thought this was the weirdest thing. And as I was about to leave, he stopped me and told me he swore he saw me before. And I asked him where. He said I was responsible for killing his mother, that I rode right over her and drove off.
Oh my God.
And then what?
Then nothing. I told him I had a clean driving record. During the time it happened, I didn't even live around here.
And he believed you, huh?
I don't know. He just sort of gave me this look I can't explain. But maybe he thought I was lying. But he just went off on his way.
That is weird.
You still go on those jogs?
Hell no!
Peter and April will buy this out for a hike.
Tomorrow?
Yeah.
I'm guessing it's an all-day thing.
It's an 8-mile hike.
Yeah, I don't know about that, Ann.
Why not? We're both free tomorrow.
I really need to clean up the shop.
You can't miss one day of cleaning.
No, I really can't.
Come on, Edward. I already told them we could make it.
Well, you shouldn't have been able to answer without talking to me first.
All right, I'll text April and let her know.
All right.
Oh, since I have a free day tomorrow, I'll come by the shop and help out.
Wait.
Mm-hmm.
I'm getting tired of cleaning that place every day. I could use a break.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
You changed your mind awful quick on that.
I know, I'm sorry. I'm just all over the place. I honestly could use a break. Oh, this place is driving me crazy.
Okay. But one day soon, I'm coming by and helping you clean out that place.
One day.
Eduard? Oh my God, are you okay?
I'm fine. Just a little tired.
You're working yourself to death. And you're stubble.